Hello, my friends. Let's continue our journey on IMO 2021. This is Red Pig. Don't forget to subscribe if you like my videos. Our second problem is to prove that for any real numbers x1 to xn, summing up the square root of the absolute value on xi plus xj is larger than summing up the same thing on xi minus xj. This problem looks really tricky because we need to handle both the absolute value and the square root. If you want to try it, pause the video here. The solution is coming right away. To get a better sense on the problem, let's start with some small cases. For n equals to 1, it is trivial because the left hand side is positive and the right hand side is 0. Now for the case n equals to 2, it already requires some work. Let's assume that x2 is larger than x1 in absolute value. Then the left hand side is lower bounded by 2 times square root of 2x1 plus 2 times square root of x1 plus x2. Now using the fact that the square root of x plus the square root of y is larger than the square root of x plus y, and together with the triangle inequality, we get what we want. Then the very first idea come to my mind is to apply induction. Let's try to do it in a naive way. If we want to induct from n equals to 1 to n equals to 2, we isolate all the terms related to x2 and try to prove that this part highlighted in the red block holds by itself. Unfortunately, this is not true. Especially when x2 equals to minus x1, things can go really bad. In this case, the right hand side in the red box is twice of the left hand side, so we really need to include the first term to make it work. Even though this naive way does not work out, it gives us an interesting observation that the inequality is tight when x1 plus x2 equals to 0. So let's try to see what happened in a more general situation if we impose this condition. Let's say x2 equals to minus x1 equals to a. Then we can expand the left hand side as follows. We get 2 times square root of 2a plus square root of xi minus a and square root of xi plus a plus some other terms. These terms are symmetric in the sense that we get both minus a and plus a. So let's check the right hand side. Indeed, we get exactly the same thing because minus of minus a is plus a. This means if we find two opposite numbers in the sequence, then we reduce the inequality to a case of n minus 2 variables, which allows us to perform induction. Now comes the tricky question. How can we even make sum of the xi plus xj equals to 0? The key observation is when we shift the numbers by a constant, the right hand side does not change. So we have an additional parameter alpha to play with. Adjusting alpha can make the sum of xi and xj equals to 0. For example, taking the average of x1 and x2 will make the first two elements sums up to 0. This is great. Next, we need to compare the sum of the square root before and after shifting. Ideally, if the shifting decreases the square root of xi plus xj to yi plus yj, then we can apply the induction on yi and get what we want because the difference between yi and yj is the same as the difference between xi and xj. So what it remains is to find out this inequality in question mark. In the best scenario, when all the terms xi plus xj are positive, we can do it. let's put all these numbers xi plus xj on the x-axis. Then there is one closest to the origin called A. Then shifting the entire sequence by A to the left makes the smallest sum equals to 0. And the others remain positive. Obviously, this shifting decreases the sum of the square root, which is what we want. But this is really the best scenario because we don't have any negative numbers. Once the negative numbers present, like those green dots, shifting to the left will increase the absolute value of those negative numbers. So we really need to differentiate between positive and negatives. Let me introduce more notations. We use P to denote all the pairs I and J, such that xi plus xj is positive, and n to denote the negative pairs. We define A as the minimum of xi plus xj among the positive set, and B is the maximum of xi plus xj among the negative set. To visualize it, on the x-axis, those two points represent the ones closest to the origin in different directions. Now we consider two shiftings, one to the left by A, the other to the right by B. For the sequence y, when I and j is a positive pair, xi plus xj is larger than A. This means the absolute value of yi plus yj is xi plus xj minus A. In contrast, when I and j is a negative pair, the sum of them is negative. Therefore, the absolute value changes the sign, becoming A minus xi minus xj. This can also be written as xi plus xj in absolute value plus A. In other words, the square root on the positive part decreases, while the square root on the negative part increases. Similarly, the sequence z also enjoys this phenomenon, but in the reverse direction. Then note that the square root function is concave. By Jensen's inequality, the weighted sum on the square root of x minus a and the square root of x plus b compensate to each other. In particular, if we pick the coefficient carefully, the weighted sum is smaller than the square root of x. A similar inequality holds for x plus a and x minus b as well. Now we multiply the first row by b over a plus b and the second row by a over a plus b. Sum them up give us xi plus xj is larger than the weighted sum of yi plus yj and zi plus zj. Since both of yi and zi are obtained by shifting, they have some opposite elements by construction. Therefore, each of them reduces to a case of n minus 2 variables, and we can apply induction. Hence, they are larger than the sum of yi minus yj and the sum of zi minus zj. Finally, these two terms are identical to xi minus xj. And we are done. Voila, that's it. I find the problem really hard because we don't have many options to deal with the absolute values. The key is really to discover the invariance property under shifting, which allows us to move the sequence around. Finally, we break the square root by Jensen's inequality. I hope you enjoyed the solution. See you next time. Bye bye.